Welcome back, everyone. Each year, so many special memories are made in our homes during the Christmas season. Man, oh man, they just come up when you say that too, don't they? So Paige has come up with a creative way to make sure that those memories come with us wherever we move.
Yes, I know, you look at me like we move a lot.
Well, and yeah, exactly, so we brought in the expert of moving.
Yes, no, actually, I was inspired, not by my own life, but by Hallmark Movies and Mysteries' Last Vermont Christmas.
Right.
It stars Aaron Cahill, who plays Megan, and Justin Bruning, who plays Nash. So in the movie, Megan returns home to Vermont for Christmas, and she and her two sisters are surprised to learn that their parents are selling their childhood home, making it, dun dun dun, their last Christmas in Vermont. She's even more surprised to find out the buyer is her old high school sweetheart, Nash, who plans on renovating the house.
Uh-huh.
What is he gonna do with all that stuff?
Well,
I like wanna go in and tell her if she takes apart, if Nash takes apart any of it.
Yeah.
Take it with you to your next place.
Which is basically what we're gonna be doing
now,
right?
We're gonna do now, yes. You can take old things from your house and upcycle them to make these adorable little Christmas trees. And it's a great reminder of the Christmases that you've had in that great house.
I think it's a really nice idea. And I know that you sort of figured out ways to, you know, specifically use sentimental pieces if we can, right?
If we can.
So what's the first step and what do we got here? What are we
working with? I went with spindles because if someone is remodeling a staircase, the spindles are so great because they're so pretty.
Yeah.
But you could do crown molding. You could even take 2x4s if you know somebody's knocking out a wall or something. You just want to make anything that's sentimental, you know, just take it with you.
Because you find when you're coming into a house, oftentimes things are left over in the basement or in the garage, or
these
are things that are lying around the house that you can, you know, take with you when you go.
Exactly, and we'll always remind you.
Great.
So I've chosen spindles, and since I didn't have a home to remodel, my mom is actually still in her house since 1974. I went online and purchased these, and you can buy spindles. So these are regular spindles, what you see here.
Yes.
Now look at these cute little guys.
Yeah.
These are called craft spindles, and they come in a variety of sizes. So I thought they were so adorable. So use the regular stair spindles, the craft spindles, and then this is just a dowel, a round dowel and a square dowel.
Exactly.
To use
like
to kind of fill
one.
It out.
Right, okay.
Yep,
right,
yep.
And so do you cut these down or do you use them and you kind of like stack them in a certain way?
You stack them, yeah, and I really wanted to cut, I wanted it to be 24 inches at the bottom and then you're gonna go up to taper like a Christmas tree.
Got it.
Obviously these are too big. So what you wanna do, I just laid them out on top of each other and I went in a half inch on each side. So let's focus on this side right now.
Got it.
And then once they were cut,
you
know, you just kind of keep going, place that in,
place
that in. So this is how I did it, and I'm sure there's a more scientific way to do it than what I did,
I don't know.
I just went in, marked half an inch on each side.
Yep.
On that side, I went over here, did the same thing, like marked there.
Right, we're not lining up this side right now, everybody, but you get the idea. But this is how you would cut them.
This is how you would cut them, like just a little bit off of each of
these. Yeah, this guy's ready to go.
That one's ready to go.
Yeah.
And then you fill it in with your little craft ones.
Okay.
Towards the top.
How fun.
So, and whatever materials you can use, you don't have to just use spindles or just use crown molding. You can do whatever you have in the house.
And sometimes the natural wood looks so nice, you know, that authentic natural wood.
But sometimes
And sometimes it does. And sometimes you want to add a little stain, you want to add a little color, maybe a little antiquing.
I added chalk paint to these to make them look old. Because chalk
all
paint
of the above.
Is matte.
Yep.
And then I sanded it back.
Okay.
You know, those
are
extra.
I feel like I should be helping you lift stuff.
You can hand me that.
Okay, great.
And I sanded it back. So I used this chalk matte finish, and then I sanded it back to give it really that old style look.
Cool.
And now I've attached these with, this is my favorite trick of doing wood glue and hot glue, because both of them together will give you that nice strong bond. One is instant and one sets up over time. So wait, let's make sure these are in the right place. I've painted some.
So it's in, like just as you're doing right now, it's important to kind of lay it out first before you kind of go in there with the glue, like I would have to do.
Before you want to make that commitment.
Yeah, exactly.
You want to make sure that things look good. And if we're happy and we're good to go, we can lock it in. You like it?
Is that, that looks good to me.
That looks good, and I'm going to save
this
for the top.
Can you guys see that at home?
I'm going to save that, for the top. So we can hold it up as soon as we are done. So we're starting right
there. We start right here.
Okay.
So right on the guy or right
actually,
on
just put a tiny bead on the board, and I'm going to add some just on the places that's going to be contact on the board. That is good.
Is that a tiny bead or is that?
Well, I could go a little less maybe. Just a smidge.
When you say tiny.
Yes. Well, and I want to say too, these are really, I mean, we could probably just do these with hot glue, but if you have really big pieces, especially this one, this is my 24-incher, you might even want to put a screw in on the backside just to make sure that it is, it will stay.
Yeah.
Because glue will hold. It'll do the job. It'll work. But if you want that extra stability, I would use a screw.
That's a good piece of advice. I also want to ask you about the trunk of the tree. What did you use for that?
Those were blocks that I had left over from another DIY. And so they're, all I did was paint them brown.
Yeah.
And thank you. All I did was paint them brown and sand them back to give that kind of trunk look and to have it match everything. So are we at our last one?
We're getting there.
Okay.
Stay with us, everybody.
Okay. I'm gonna steal some of that glue right there.
And as we're kind of finishing these up, I can ask you, I know it's a little bit before that we're gonna do this, but how would you hang it? How would you recommend hanging
this? I would lean this, because I really like something to kind of lean up against the wall.
Yeah.
But you could also, if you wanted to hang it on the wall, you would use a French cleat, my favorite thing to use. I'm gonna add a little bit more there, just because it is going to be heavy since we're putting this on plywood.
It's gonna be heavy, and the other great thing about a French cleat is you know exactly like the level, you know it's level because
yes.
you put the part on the wall that's perfectly level, you just gotta get up there and toss it on.
You do that first, and then for the bow, I'm just putting a little bit of hot glue.
Nice.
I tied this bow earlier, and you guys be careful with the hot glue. It is no fun to burn yourself. Exhibit A, you can see some of my fingers.
Let me just tilt it up so people can see.
Okay.
I'm not going to do the full lift yet. I know the glue is just driving.
Yep, glue is driving. Drying.
I just said driving.
And I backed you up on that.
That looks so good, Paige.
Thank you.
And what
very
a
much.
Great way to take sentimental pieces of your home with you wherever you move. Well
wherever
done.
Wherever so you
go ahead.
Go.
You can, do you want me to help lifting that?
Yep.
You got that.
So this I'm going to put on our mantle. And, you know, if you have any presents that you want to give me, you can just put them right underneath.
Underneath that tree, everybody. Make sure you go to HallmarkChannel.com. Full instructions will be there. And don't forget to watch Last Vermont Christmas tonight on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries at 9, 8 Central.